Welcome, and today we're going to look at one of my favorite subjects. Let's look at some ancient grids. And this is a comment that was just shared with me by Alan Spence, directing us to stolenhistory.org, a fascinating site, and this particular thread dealing with these ancient grids that I so very love. And there is no end to what can be seen, proving a past civilization. These are some of the oldest earthworks and infrastructure, so old, oftentimes they are not even given any credit or explanation. The reshaping of coastlines, canal systems, intricate ports, grids, in some cases for hundreds of miles, with no explanation. Lines cutting through rugged terrain with changing elevation, with a perfection that would be very difficult to replicate today. And oftentimes these lines are not affected by overgrowth of brush. They somehow maintain their visibility, and more often than not, their purpose is completely not understood. So this thread starts out with this really interesting book, Growing Artificial Societies. Just fascinating that such a book even exists, and I look forward to having a look at this. Here is the author. And here, let's just jump into some grid patterns. This is a perfect example. And if these are anywhere near developed areas with a population, they quickly become roads and farms and various uses and serve as an excellent foundation for development. But what makes no sense is when they're in the middle of nowhere. Oftentimes, one of this nature would become an airport. Very convenient repurposing, if needed. And this particular section is in Canada. And here, taking a little jump to someone's personal Flickr album, we can have a look at a nice showcase of some of these grids. And this is very exciting. I do love a showcase, nice and organized. And here we'll start out with Alaska. An excellent example. At a first glance, looking like a city. And again, perfect foundations. Here's an excellent one. Almost having a crop circle feel, but even more fascinating. Something less temporary. And even here, this is almost in another category. Not so grid-like, but clearly a purpose. And a little closer look. And like I was saying, changing the vegetation. Almost leaving perhaps a frequency behind that acts as a natural herbicide, allowing for the definition of these lines to remain. Very fascinating. And here are some other little offshoot patterns. As if our minds aren't blown enough. A little close up here. And yes, another underlying pattern that I hadn't initially noticed. And these are in Alaska. Middle of nowhere. Some of the greatest ones have simply been turned into military bases, but you can only have so many military bases and so many farms. And if these are found near water, we end up with canal-type systems. And here again, a grid with some other kind of imprint as well. And here, many times we do see this. Along a line, a water reservoir. And this is very, very typical when doing this research. Here again, a look at that. And this one is very interesting. Really at a loss of words when examining these. Coming from both a alternative and I'm sure a mainstream perspective. Very difficult to understand what we may be seeing here. And I would love to hear your comments. Some of the strangest of my research. Here again, seeming very purposeful and intentional and very beautiful. Here a little closer. And what purpose could this be, a terraforming? And as we can see, what the author of this showcase has titled this, The Search for Sleeping Giants. Very appropriate. For an average human, such a feat would most probably be impossible. Especially, like I said, to keep the vegetation from either not growing or growing in the appropriated lands. And here's one in Mexico. In one of the first videos I ever made on this subject, I was showing grids on the shores of the Salt Lake in Utah. And a lot of people told me these were salt farms. And again, very easy to explain away if they're in a close proximity to civilization. But in cases like this, unused, and yet clearly looking like the remains of a past civilization. This may have been some industrial site, and in a past reset, has been washed clean, and all we see is an imprint. Let's have a little look at Iraq. Some pictures out in the desert, really showing up nicely in the desert. And of course, some of the first pictures I ever saw depicting these ancient lines, or not so ancient, were in Peru many, many, many years ago, hearing discussions on late-night talk radio about the massive spider and hummingbird that could be seen from above. And it's as if whoever made all of these other works had just been doodling out in Peru. And perhaps these are just abstract doodles, but I don't think so. I think there is a purpose. What people, in what time period, unclear. But what is certain is these are the foundation of our realm. All of our cities and major feats of architecture lay on these lines, and many times being very organized and seeming like circuitry. And in cases like this, uncertain. What is clear is these are not natural. And again, we are in Iraq. No paved roads, very little signs of modern civilization. And we do often see a modern road, and the modern roads being not as straight and perfectly engineered as the older ones. And this is really fascinating, with these little divots along the road and signs of prior civilization. Now this is a great example. These look like perhaps some modern vehicle tracks. All crazy. We can clearly differentiate the old from the new. Here a little close up. And all of this is in Iraq. A rather large showcase. I believe there was 150 photos in this one alone. And this is one of the more beautiful ones I've ever seen. Some sort of spiral, and really not seeming to be any signs of civilization. And even here in this little lagoon, much work has been taken into shaping this, and all of the coastline seeming artificial, as if every detail in this realm was planned and laid out long before we arrived, we being naive to this wonder. And look at this. This is probably massive, absolutely amazing, and it would be pointless to speculate on its purpose, but clearly having a purpose. Here being the site of a great city, here is a clear footprint of civilization. And here was their road, here was probably their train, and now nothing. Out in the middle of nowhere. Here a little closer look, if it wasn't clear enough. Absolutely fascinating. And how massive was this towering structure in which we're only seeing the footprint of. Here a little look at this track. I would love to teleport here immediately. Have a look. Absolutely amazed. And here again, seeming to be the shadows for some columns. Really mind-blowing. I wish we had some Google Earth coordinates. Nothing, it seems. Wow. And I think before my head explodes, I'll take a pause. One more little look. I saw this down here. And now, if this was in America, for example, in the United States, this would quickly become a military base. But out here, in the desert of Iraq, much has been preserved. And it does seem like it has become something, some kind of industrial site. Easy repurposing for industrial applications. And for the masses, bringing some sort of closure to the mystery. Here's a nice one in Egypt. And I shared this one once. Somebody sent me a link to the image, and I never was able to find it on Google Earth. And very fascinating that I should be reunited. And really, we have to consider the famous Burning Man event, really resembling something like this. They turning it into a temporary city for a week or two. Very beautiful. And here's some interesting ones in Idaho, not too far from me. Very strange, seeming like some identifying markers, perhaps some language, and these squiggly lines with what appear to have water in them. Very fascinating. Idaho, typically a pretty dry state, very beautiful state. And here we go. Something that seems very much like lettering. And again, a very nice showcase. And I thank you, creator of this. Very nice organizing of these anomalies. And down here at the end, we see another 1,200 plus photos that need sorting and are titled as such. Oh, how we lose track of time when we're enjoying ourselves. But for this week, I think that's it. I thank you so much for joining me. Thank you for all your kind support. Do have a blessed day. Please like, comment, and subscribe.